quite obvious that Soccer Evan is here.
You definitely have the fans, the weather, everything. The field's nice. Everything, that all the work that everyone puts into this place, it is Soccer Evan.
We have the best fans in America, and they show up to every game committed, throwing tortillas after every goal. Just playing here has just been a real, real experience for me. It's like playing in a pro culture. I mean, you don't get this many fans in MLS sometimes.
Kind of came around as a marketing term of which everything else could come under, and we were trying to find something that was as big as what's happening here in Santa Barbara. Our athletic department does a great job of marketing, and next thing you know, we had Soccer Heaven everywhere.
Party rock, looking for your girl. girl, she on me jock, huh? Now stop when we in the spot. Booty moving weight like she on the block. With a drink, I got to know. Tight jeans tattoo, cause I'm rockin' wrong. Half black, half white, domino. Gang of money.
Yeah, I'm running through these halls like Drano. I got that devilish flow, rock and roll, no halo. We party rock, yeah, that's the clue that I'm repping. On a rise to the top, no letting our Zeppelin.
Hey,
party rockers in the house tonight. Woo! Everybody just have a good time.
Yeah,
and we gon' make you lose your mind. Everybody just have a good time.
Let's go.
Party rock is in the house.
And welcome to a mecca for college soccer, home to the UC Santa Barbara Gauchos, who welcome in the reigning national champion Akron Zips. This is the NSCA Men's Game of the Week. I welcome in my broadcast partner, Keith the Batsy. Keith, make no mistake about it, this is a game we've circled for a long time.
No, it has. I mean, it's not often you get a non-conference game in October like this. And Akron defending champs, a huge bullseye on their back. And Santa Barbara, they have a national championship in their repertoire as well. They'd like to get back to it. They need a signature win, and this is the opportunity. Akron keeps the ball so well. Santa Barbara here at home has to go at them, keep possession themselves, and pressure them high upfield to have a chance to have that win tonight.
All right, Keith, we talked to both coaches about this big time matchup.
Tonight, obviously, the simple answer is we have to put the ball in the back of the net, which has been kind of our Achilles heel so far in the last few games. But good game. It'll be a great opportunity for us to play against a very, very good team and get them at home.
Kippy will square it. Dueno. The Gaucho sent across, wide open, and a finish! 1-1! Silva! Tortillas!
The tortillas are coming for Luis Silva's goal. An excellent cross. Silva getting in on the back post. Unmarked there. And boy, has that got to be a lot of weight off the shoulders of Santa Barbara players right now after having so many chances. And we see this again. Getting down, the ball slipped through just on sides. Saul getting that ball across, and Silva wide open at the back post. Easy side of the foot into the goal. And equalizes it, Luis Silva with his sixth goal of the year.
Sent across, the Gauchos looking for more, right for the net, and it's in, the Gauchos on top!
With Dan Kennedy bringing good luck to Santa Barbara.
And we've always depended on timely finishing.
And there's the timely finish as you come in. Dom Saul with the finish. Have another look at this. Santa Barbara just continues to get in there. Crossed by Kiffy, kept alive. And then Saul there, what a clever touch over top. And then over top of Mavis. And this is an excellent goal by Dom Saul. And all the credit to Santa Barbara keeping that ball in. What cleverness inside the 18 there. First of all, screening off his defender, flicking it over one defender, and then just casually putting it past Mavis for the goal. And all of a sudden, two goals for Santa Barbara in a short period of time, 2 minutes.
Yeah, that looked like a finish that deserves to be the game winner.
Overtime here in Santa Barbara. UCSB 2, Akron 2, the reigning national champs, back where they won it all 1 year ago. And it's been a good one, Keith. And the fans would love to celebrate one here in overtime.
No, they would, and certainly Santa Barbara has had a little bit of the upper hand. And, you know, 15 shots for Santa Barbara, 11 for Akron in that regulation, and see what happens. It's just one shot that counts now in the overtime.
Overtime has been a regular part of the game of the week. UCSB, Silva, dropped in, Garza. Boy, he thought he could just get a little piece of that back heel. Noni was there. Kiffey down near the end line. Kiffey stays with it. Kiffey crosses, and a finish! UCSB wins!
Well, I'll tell you what. Dean Linke, look at that. It was Luis Silva getting on the end of James Kiffey. We're talking about James Kiffey being right in. Second goal of the game winner. A signature win we talked about for Santa Barbara against Akron.